project, and this is having very importance in the whole society and result in the whole world. And your day-to-day life, we are using it in a maximum manner. So let us consider about something. And today we are going to discuss the technology with some objectives. And today the learning objective is like, we are going to talk about what is the basic motivation to learn the network topology. Then we will introduce the computer network topology, then followed by different type of network topology that exist over here, and the advantage and disadvantage of each topology. And along with that, at the last we will talk about the overall advantage and disadvantage of topology, then some practical applications of topology, and a particular case study how the topology could be applied over there. Then we will conclude the things with a remark, some references. Okay, these are the basic topic of today's discussion. And according to start with, let us think about the situation. Now you see the situations. Nowadays you will talk about the global world. Nowadays the global world is like this, a lot of devices are there. How to connect the devices? So these are the basic things. Now we think about the today's digital connected world. The network topology is just a concept of IT professionals. But it is not limited to IT only, because it is useful in everywhere. Now consider about the challenge. So this is the challenge. Think about the situation. Think about the situation. Suppose you are in a very large corporation and you have a lot of people that are working onshore and offshore, maybe globally in the remote offices. Now how you will connect? How will you connect among these people? So that is the biggest challenge, and the solution for the challenge lies here. So the answer lies in today's discussion, that is your computer network topologies. Think about another situation like, see, if you think about the today's world, today's internet, how the internet works. Because in internet, various people, then you have various contents, and you want to explore various contents from various resources. Now the question is, how these things were communicated, and how you have to communicate and checking and the sharing of the information among different users. And that is possible because of the today's discussion, what we are going to discuss in the computer network. And think about another situation. See, by 2025, world globally we are expecting 75 billions of connected devices, like your mobile, laptop, computer. 75 billion devices will be. And practically if you consider about it, each and every individual who have or had, it is coming not less than 4 devices you are going to handle. Maybe your laptop, maybe your desktop, maybe your mobile, some other devices. Now you consider in that situation how will you manage the things, and how will you communicate with others, how different people they communicate among themselves. For this purpose, the today's discussion is nothing but the computer topology will resolve these issues. Now think about another situation. If you want to imagine, suppose you think about a large corporation and you are assigned that yes, you just establish the corporation with various components. Then how will you communicate the component? How will you connect the components? So in that case, you also need to consider about the factors like your network topology will help you to communicate among these things. Okay. Now let me take another situation. Now think about the globe. Think about the spiral sort of thing. Think about the complexity of different type of people, how they are connecting and interacting among themselves. So for this purpose also you need to have a discussion of network topology. And think about the today's situation. Today's situation you think. So just how the smartphone, laptop, they are connecting to the internet and they are seeking and sharing the information among them. How they are connected, how they are sharing their information, how they are getting their information, how they are posting their information, different type of activities goes on, and how will you manage the things. And for this purpose also you do have a solution that is your network topology. You think about today's situation, you see the picture and see. See, nowadays the things are global. So if you want to see, is the whole remote work, online education system, a lot of mechanism goes on, everything you can learn from the internet online manner. In that case also, you have to go for the network topology. If you have the idea about network topology, you can learn a lot of things, you can do a lot of things, a lot of efficient interaction can be done. So, to conclude the things, it will come for the network topology because a lot of terms were discussed about the computer network topology. So, what is the topology? The topology is nothing but the structure of the network. If you think about the structure of the network, that is nothing but. That means how you have to define the network, how you have to place the components, how the different components have to be arranged about themselves so that efficiently they have to be communicated and there should be an interconnectivity about the components. How will you do that? And further proposed, you have two basic mechanisms, two basic. One is your physical topology and another is your logical topology. If you talk about physical topology, geographically how you arrange it? That means geometric representation of the nodes in the network is treated as your physical topology. But we will focus more on the logical topology. What exactly logical topology? In the concept of the network, that how the architecture, what should be the architecture, how different nodes will communicate among themselves by using different type of inter-networking devices like your routers, switches and various components. And dynamically sometimes some new devices will come, sometimes some devices will go out, exit, some devices may be obsolete. On that situation, how will you manage the things? So dynamically you have to manage it, you can reconfigure, all these things will be done by the logical topology. So this is the basic idea behind a network topology. Now we will talk about what is the importance of the network topology. If you talk about the importance of network topology, so there are five important aspects. One is your efficient data flow, that means how we have to connect so that the data will flow very efficiently in a very reliable manner from device to device without any interrupt. That is the number one goal. Number one importance is your scalability. Because see, today you may have some limited number of devices. So far 2022, we have around 37 devices components. But we are expecting in 2025, it's going to be 75 billions of devices. That means gradually the things are changes, the devices changes. So if the changes, how we have to accommodate it, how we have to adapt, that is called your scalability. That means how the business, without disturbing the business, how we have to communicate. That is the second aspect. And third importance is your fault tolerance. Suppose you are communicating through a component. If by any means, if some devices fail, then how you manage the things? Sometimes you might have observed the things, your server is down. So in that case, you should have the mechanism like what should be the alternative so that the downtime should be maintained in a very flexible manner. That should be the, and second, the fourth one is your security. Because if you want to communicate the things, you should have a provision like how it has to be, how your data or the information what you are going to communicate should be secured and how it has to be protected from the unauthorized access. That should be the goal. And the resource optimization is the major importance of implementing a network topology. So your message, your resource optimization comes how the components could be utilized in a maximum manner. That should be the goal. And how, with a very minimal cost, how will you manage the things? And how will you manage so that efficiently the communication is to go? So these are the basic importance of why you have to go for network topology. Okay? So here, if you talk about the network topology, what is its role? What is the role of network topology in our data communication? In our data communication, number one, network topology, if you have the network topology, your data routing will be convenient and efficient enough. Because path, whatever path to take to transport your data from one device to another device, that will be defined by the, if you have a network topology. That means the data routing would be specified. And second one is the redundancy. That means, see, by any means, if you have a fault, your system should not get breakdown. You should have an alternative, like how efficiently you will manage, how to manage the thing, so that if the fault could not be realized, you should not realize the user that, yes, system will have fault. That you should eradicate. The second one. Third one is scalability. Already I told you the things, the ability to accommodate the growth. When the growth becomes more and more, how you have to accommodate the things, so that without any hindrance, the things will go ahead. And the role of topology in your data communication is matter is your performance. In performance, the data transfer should be speed. And the real life, it should be protected in the real life applications, like basically in the video conferencing you are using. If you have an interrupt, then the flow will come. There will be a mismatch between the voice and the image. That should be, so if you have a proper, well-defined network topology, so you could perform, the performance could be high. And security is the major aspect. The security could be maintained in the data communication if you have a network. So you are isolating, controlling the SSH and providing the safeguard to the SSH. Okay, so these are the basic things of how. So before going for any topology, but now the question comes, which type of topology will adapt? Which type of topology will be adapted? What should be the mechanism of topology so that we can manage the things in an efficient manner? So before constructing or developing the structure of the network, topology is nothing but the structure of the network. The structure of the network has to be defined by considering some factors. Like number one factor is you should consider about the cost. You are saying my device, my network is good, efficient enough, but what about the cost? If your cost is high, then probably majority of the people cannot afford it. Very few will afford it. So that you have to take the concern. That means cost is a major factor where you have to think about the establishment of the network infrastructure. Now how you have to establish the things? How many cable segments are there? What is the distance between the node? How you have to manage the thing so that with a less number of cable segments you can manage the things. Less number of you can manage the things. So what is the server? Where you have to place the server? How you have to configure so that efficiently the things manage and with a very less cost, how you have to manage the total network? That is the number one. That is the first consideration. Second one, you have to consider about the flexibility. See, if you don't have the flexible enough, then suppose once you constructed the network, second time if it needs a more complicated situation to handle, then nobody will prevent. So you have to make it flexible enough so that reconfiguration. Maybe set up or relocating, re-existing, that could be managed in a very efficient manner. That should be the top management flexibility. Then third, you have to consider about the reliability. If any time, any fault comes, then if background comes, easily you could have the alternative mechanisms to handle the things. That should be there. And fourth consideration is scalability. Because today the company's network may be 5 employees, 10 employees, maybe 100 employees. Tomorrow the company will grow large. Number of employees will go, number of devices will go, number of connectivity will go. Do we have the mechanism to manage it or not? If you don't have the mechanism, if you have a fixed set of things, then probably people will not prepare. You should have the mechanism to extend it. If a new device comes, you should have the accommodability. That comes under your scalability. And it will come from the easy of installation. If the installation is very difficult, nobody will prepare it, so you should make it easy. Nowadays, almost all the things, people will have the provisions like your plug and play facility comes nowadays. Plug and play. No need to rewrite the device drivers and other things. If you have to plug and you can work. So that's not easy thing. That is hardware, software, some technical professionals are not required to manage everything every time. That mechanism should be there. So last one is easy of maintenance. Once you establish everything is fine, then next time if any problem comes, maintenance should be very easy. So these are some of the factors you have to consider. By considering these factors, you have to go for structuring a network for an organization or any business. Okay? Now the question comes, if you consider about the things, the whole idea is there are some devices, the devices want to communicate. First, you should look at the picture like a point-to-point communication. Anytime, if two devices one-to-one, one should be a source and there should be a destination or receiver. So source will send your sender will send the information, receiver will receive the information. And sometimes like the receiver will send and sender will come. So it's a different type of mechanisms they could adapt, like you have the simplex, duplex, full duplex, all these different mechanisms are there that will work given you. But if you have more than one, two devices, then how do you manage? In the real situation, if you think about the things, practically, in every situation, there won't be any two devices. Multiple devices are there. If multiple devices, then how will you manage the things? Then you have to think about different type of topology. Then you think about the topology. There are various type of topology, like your host topology, ring topology, star topology, tree topology, mesh topology, and you have the hybrid topology. So we'll talk about one by one. So first we will start with the bus topology. Now let us see about these things. Now we consider bus. bus is moving from one point to another point, maybe from Kharagpur to Gopalpur, bus is moving. What happens actually? Bus stops, and in different points, bus stops, some gets down, some gets up. It's happening. Different points, some will get down, some will get up, like this, from the source to the destination. Here also the mechanism is same, or most of the species in our groups. See, there are various roads. For example, in this case, you have five different roads, and you have a long cable which is connected. And it's connected to each node. Any node can be sent some information to any other node. Those who are sending are the senders. Those who are intended to receive, they are the receivers. This is the situation. Now, what is the concept behind it? The concept behind it is the bus network is basically it's a linear transmission cable they are running. Maybe preferably they are the coaxial cables, and they are running, and which connects network. Different number of devices they are connecting, different workstations they are connecting throughout the southern lanes. And the second parameter is the server is at one end of the bus, and when the workstation has the data to send, the transmission of the packets from the source to the destination has to go to the bus. So in this case, the data travels in both the directions. Okay. Now see, the destination terminal sits and copies. Once the data comes, moves from the source to the destination. Once it reaches at the destination will copy it to the interface. Okay? So this is the whole mechanism that moves. What is the advantage if you apply this type of network? So if you are adapting this bus topology, it's easy. Installation will be easy and maintenance. Second one is extendable. Like you can extend the cable, you can extend any number of devices. And very reliable because only one single transmission line you are using, so it's reliable. Okay, so that is the situation. Now, what are the disadvantages of this one? The disadvantage is troubleshooting. Because if you have there is no single point, any node can transmit the things, any node. So, troubleshooting is difficult because no single point of control is there. Everyone, all the nodes can release them. So, that is the drawback. Secondly, is your one faulty node. If only one fault node is fault, then the whole network will break down. Okay, that is the drawback. And the dumb terminal cannot connect to the bus. If they don't have the processor, it's a dumb terminal that doesn't connect to the bus. So these are the drawbacks. So what is the solution for this drawback? Next improvement comes. We think about a ring approach. That means ring, like a ring sort of things. Each node will connect to a subsequent terminal. So 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6. Like this way, they have to connect. Okay? So, that's the reason it looks like a ring. That's the reason the ring is given as a ring topology. Okay? Now, the ring topology is basically they are connecting exactly two nodes in a circular sense. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and last will connect to the path. That is the whole mechanism, the motion. And here the data travels in a predefined direction either the clockwise or the anticlockwise. That will be defined over there. Then, when the terminal has to send data, they transmit to its neighbor. That means one will send it to 4, this one will send it to 2, 2 will send it to 3, 3 will send it to 4. Likewise, they have to move. That means every time they will send it to next node, likewise. Okay? Before transmission, it will first, it receives, it amplifies, then send. That process helps to move. Okay? So, once it reaches at the destination, so destination flag, you know, will remove it, the data, and keep it for some time, then it will. Okay, that is the whole mechanism that goes on. So what is the advantage over here? The advantage is small cable segments are required, not a very big large cable. Okay? Because small cable it connects from two nodes. And it is basically ideal for the optical fiber because that is only one direction, that is good enough. And it's very high transmission speed, is very high in this case. Because no interpretation, node to node communication goes. Okay? So these are the advantages. And what are the disadvantages over here? Here also, if one node will fail, the whole network will fail. That is the number one. Second one is troubleshooting is also very difficult. Where the problem lies, it's difficult to detect. And difficult to remove all nodes. If one node will remove, then reconfiguration, a lot of things are required. Everything not intact, everything will change. So these are the drawbacks. So about the drawbacks, another improvement comes that is your stack support. Here they are not saying that we will not depend, the devices will not depend on other devices. there is a central hub, the hub will connect to these roads. If a particular road wants to send another road, they have to send through the hub. Okay? So the whole mechanism here is the startup is in, the server is connected to each road individually, okay? And the server is also called the central node. The exchange of the data will be between two nodes and takes place through the servers. That means any road want to send, they have to send through the server only. Okay? And the server first will receive the thing. First the sender will send, it will receive by the server, over to the intended node, that will be received. And in turn, if the both two-way communication, the same messenger will be adapted to the node. So what is the advantage? The first advantage, failure of one node will not affect to the whole network, like the previous cases. If one node fail, the whole network will fail. But here, if one node will fail, that will be accelerated because that node is not directly connected to other nodes. Okay? Second one. So troubleshooting is easy because detecting, once there is any fault, that will be detected, and once thus. The next one is simple access protocols could be implemented over here because it's a one-to-one protocol. So what is the drawback of the no cable rules may not connect to each node of the server. Second one, if the hub will get problem, there is a fail in the central road for the hub, then the whole network will collapse. That is the problem. To avoid the things, if one node is problem, then problem will come. So to avoid the things, another mechanism comes, that your tree tuple. In tree tuple, it looks like a tree. In the structure, you might have read the tree. It's a tree structure. Not only always binary tree, it can be ternary trees. Okay, 3, 4, 5, any number of nodes could be there. But for the example, we are doing it, it's a binary mechanism. Okay? See, here the mechanism is, it's a proof of, it's a combination of star topology with a linear loss. You see, look at that topology over here. You see, here in this case, you see, if you talk about this topology, see, if you think about other things, you say, if you consider this one is a hub, like a star topology, this one node, this node is not having any direct connection, this one is connected through this one. So, like if you have 5 numbers, this act as a hub, so this is nothing but a star topology. This is also nothing but a star topology. And these three are connected like a cable, single cable. So it's a combination of your star and box topology. Okay? So the good features of star, good features of box has to be extracted and implemented over. And sometimes it's called your higher feature topology also. It's called your higher feature topology. So what are the advantages over here? The advantage is easily you can expand because to the node, to the hub, you can say only one cable segment has to be connected and injected. No need to reconfigure others. Okay? So it's easy for expandable and always there is a point to point. So installation will be easy. So it's well centered. If you have a temporary network, temporarily you can establish, it is more suitable on those situations. Now, what are the drawback disadvantages? So technical expertise is required over here to know all this. Failure of the backbone cable. If the backbone cable is failing, then the whole system will fail. Otherwise, all other are the advantages. And since anybody can connect, any node can be connected, so it looks like some sort of insecure. Okay, and maintenance is also difficult over here because any time you can. Okay, to avoid the things people, to make it more secure, people they think about the mesh network. Like your defense organization or somewhere you need more security without, if any system goes fault, I should not have interference. That should be the mechanism. If you have that mechanism, then you can go to switch on main server. These things, basically mesh topology will be useful in the situation where you need to have a mechanism, like you need a more secure, like defense operation. They don't want to pass the data through other nodes. On that situation, what you need to do? Direct interaction, one-to-one interaction. If there is 5 nodes, 1, 2, A, B, C, D, E, A can directly interact with B, A can directly interact with C, they can directly interact with B, they can directly interact with E. Similarly, B can directly interact with C, B can directly interact with A. That means each node who have the mechanism directly can communicate with the other nodes without any hindrance. So that they can securely send the data directly from one node, one-to-one communication in the whole computer connection. So in that situation you think, that means the whole idea is all the node can communicate to each other node. So if you go for the mechanisms, like how actually they will communicate, in this situation you think about the things. Each node will have a communication. If you have three nodes, how many connections are required? How many connections? Three nodes. 1 to 2, 1 to 3. Then 2 to 1 is already there. 2 to 3. Okay. Similarly, if you have 4 connections, on that situation, how will you manage the things? How will you manage it? If you have 4 nodes, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4. Then 1 to 2 is already there. 2 to 3, 2 to 4. Then 3 to 4. How many are there? Similarly, if you have 5, then 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 1 to 5. Then 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 5. Then 3 to 4, 3 to 5. Then 4 to 5. So, altogether, what is the general formula? N into N minus 1 by 2. Okay? What about the basic mechanism of actually the interaction goes on? Over here, how actually the communication goes on? Here, each node